have an older brother that was into hip hop. So as a little kid, my older brother started introducing me to acts like, you know, Grandmaster Flash and the Furious Five, the Cold Crush Brothers, Fantastic Five Freaks, you know, the original innovators of the whole art of hip hop culture. I was basically exposed to by my older brother. So I grew up listening to a lot of the pioneers, thanks to him.
Yeah. How much older is he than you?
He's 7 years older than me. Yeah.
Is he in the music business or anything like that?
He used to be a DJ.
Yeah.
And he taught me actually how to DJ.
Yeah.
But he was never as serious about it.
Yeah.
You know, and he was never serious enough to actually turn it into a full-fledged profession, you know? He always just kind of did it for the fun.
Yeah.
And as a hobby and as a way to just hang out with his friends and bond with his friends and stuff.
So what made you take it on as a professional? Things when your brother didn't?
I think I had a stronger passion for DJing than he did.
Mm-hmm.
And
your surroundings, maybe?
I wouldn't say my surroundings, because I was surrounded by the same influences that he was.
Mm-hmm.
Your
friends, were they also DJs? Or?
Yeah, but you know, my brother also had friends that they were DJs, and friends that were MCs and stuff. I just think that there was a connection that I just had with DJing that he didn't, you know? Although he was a DJ, I just think that I connected with the whole art just a little more intensely.
Yeah.
Therefore, there just came a point where I just felt like, you know what? I could make something of myself doing this.
Yeah.
Pretty much all through my teenage years, young adulthood, I basically people defined me as a DJ. That was kind of like what I was doing. Mainstream artists, they got exposure, but then there were
underground
artists, they got just as much exposure.
Yeah.
And especially on radio, everyone got played. Run-DMC would probably be the most mainstream artist example. But then, you know, you could also listen to
KRS-One.
People like KRS-One or Schoolie D.
Yeah.
So it was a lot more balanced. Whereas now, I feel like it's only the mainstream artists that get attention.
Yeah.
And to the point to where people feel like, you know, hip-hop is dead. Like, there is
like
no more
hip-hop. Like Nas has said
for
his new album, man.
But I think that it's all about the fans going out to search for the music. You know, it's still out there.
Yeah.
I'm considered more of an underground artist.
Yeah.
But for example, March 13th, I got a new project coming out. Hitting stores called As the Tables Turn.
Yeah.
And it's basically a DVD that's a documentary about my life, my career as a DJ, the challenges, the ups and downs, all the hardships and the successes that I've experienced in my span as a DJ all these years. And it's a project that I'm proud of, and it's a project that people would consider more underground.
Yeah.
So if you don't, as a fan, go out and search this stuff out, you'll never know that it exists. But that's one example of a hip-hop movie, let's say, that I'm, you know, it's not about bling and money and the flashy side of it all. It's all about, it's more about like the struggle of what it is to be a DJ.
Yeah.
I kind of think of the movie as like a blueprint for young aspiring DJs to go by, to avoid some of the pitfalls that are out there that you could experience signing to major labels, being a part of a group, and how success could affect the group. You know, with the Executioners, a lot of people feel that, you know, I don't know if you know, but I actually left the crew in 2004, yeah. September 2004, I left the group. And people questioned, why? Why would you leave the group? Yeah. Like, why would you leave such a...
powerful name.
Established, powerful name.
Yeah.
But I wasn't happy at that point.
Yeah.
And the movie deals with that and discusses that. And it's a look into DJing and success as a DJ that not any DJ documentaries have ever took in that angle.
Yeah.
So, you know, it's a project that I feel is unique and real informative, but if you don't go out there and search it out and support it, then yeah, you know.
So we better put some advertising up for that as well.
Yeah, well, you know, I'm doing my best to spread the word, and that's why I'm here right now in Vienna, trying to promote the movie.
Yeah.
This whole European tour that I'm on now is to spread the word out there. At least here in Europe, that this movie's about to drop, and we're actually doing screenings of the movie at every venue, every performance.